In the last class, we have seen about the DC characteristics of the differential amplifier, and in this class, we are going to discuss about the small signal equivalent circuit of differential amplifier circuit. Because we are operating the differential amplifier in the linear range, in order to understand the linear range of operation, we need to get some small signal parameters like differential gain and the common mode gain and etc. by using the small signal analysis. Okay, so this is the differential amplifier circuit using BJT. Okay, so if you draw one line here, then this side is a 1CE amplifier section and the right hand side is another CE amplifier section. Okay, if you draw the small signal equivalent circuit of BJT differential amplifier, that will be like this. Okay, here if you see, this is up to here, this is a 1 amplifier section and this right hand side is the second CE amplifier section. Here I have assumed the small signal output resistance small r naught, that is infinite. So in parallel with the GM V pi current source, we doesn't have that small r naught resistance. Okay, first of all, I have taken the Q1 transistor. For the Q1 transistor, this is the base terminal, so that I have mentioned B1. So here it is the emitter terminal, which is E1, and here it is the collector terminal, which is C1. From the base terminal to the emitter terminal, we have R pi resistance, and from the collector terminal to the emitter terminal, we have GM V pi source, okay, which was mentioned here, and we have neglected the small R naught resistance. So at the input side of our Q1 transistor, we have VB1. Okay, so VB1 is mentioned, which was connected between the ground to the base terminal, and also we have taken the RB resistance, that is a biasing resistor, or else we can also take it as a source resistance. Okay, so which is a source resistance of the VB1, or else we can also assume it as a biasing resistor. And at the output side, from the collector terminal to the ground terminal, we have a resistance RC, okay, which was mentioned here, from the C terminal to the ground terminal. Actually, the V plus is grounded and the V minus is also grounded as we are doing the small signal analysis. And also, this constant current source IQ can be replaced with its equivalent resistance R naught. Here, the capital R naught is the equivalent resistance of this constant current source IQ. So from this emitter terminal to the ground, so we have mentioned the R naught resistance, which is the internal resistance of this IQ current source. And for the second CE amplifier section, this is a base terminal, which is represented as B2, and this one is the emitter terminal, which is E2, and this one is the collector terminal, which is C2. So from the B2 terminal to the E2 terminal, we have R pi resistance, and from the collector terminal to the emitter terminal, we have GM V pi current source. Here the voltage across R pi resistance is V pi 2, and at the input side, the voltage across this R pi resistance is V pi 1, so that this current source value is GM into V pi 1, like that we have mentioned. And the output side of that second transistor, we have one RC resistance from the C2 terminal to the ground terminal, which was mentioned here. And we are going to take the output across the collector terminals of these transistors. Therefore, VC1 is the output voltage across the transistor Q1, and VC2 is the output voltage of the transistor Q2 across the collector terminal. Okay, so this is the small signal equivalent circuit of this differential amplifier using BJT. Okay, and we are assuming the two transistors are identical transistor, so that the value of R pi 1, which will be equal to R pi 2. Okay, because the Q1 and Q2 are identical transistors. Okay, therefore R pi 1 is equal to R pi 2 is equal to R pi, and the transconductance gains GM1 is equal to GM2 is equal to GM. So that here directly we have mentioned gm and gm in the equivalent circuit. Now we are going to apply the KCL at node VE. At the node VE, there are the four incoming currents and one outgoing current. Okay, the four incoming currents are, one is through the R pi resistance of the Q1, and another one is a GM into V pi 1, and the third current is GM into V pi 2, and the fourth current is the current through the resistance R pi from the Q2 transistor, and only one outgoing current, that is equal to the IQ current. Okay, here IQ current can be given as voltage divided by resistance, VE divided by R0, like that. Okay, so if you write the KCL equation at node VE, we can get it like the current through the R pi resistance, which is V pi 1 divided by R pi, plus the current GM V pi 1 plus the current GM V pi 2, okay, incoming currents, plus the current through the R pi resistance in the Q2 transistor is V pi 2 divided by R pi, okay, which is equal to only one outgoing current, that is equal to IQ, that is nothing but a voltage divided by resistance, VE divided by R0, because the voltage at this node is VE and the resistance is R0. This is the equation number 1, so which is nothing but the KCL equation at node VE. And now we can rearrange this equation, because these two terms are containing the V pi 1 and V pi 1, so that we can take the V pi 1 as common. If you take V pi 1 as a common in this section, okay, we will get 1 by R pi plus GM. Okay, if you take LCM, which is R pi, if you take LCM, which is R pi, then we can get as 1 plus GM into R pi in the numerator. Okay, so here GM into R pi is nothing but beta, therefore we can write it as 1 plus beta divided by R pi. So if these two terms, V pi 1 divided by R pi plus GM into V pi 1, can be written as 1 plus beta by R pi. Okay, here V pi 1 into 1 plus beta divided by R pi. And similarly, these two terms here, GM into V pi 2 plus GM into V pi 2 divided by R pi, that can be written as V pi 2 into 1 plus beta divided by R pi. That is equal to VE by R0. So, which is a rearranged equation of the equation number 1, that is equation number 2, where GM R pi is nothing but beta. And from the circuit, we can say that the V pi 1 divided by R pi, here V pi 1, which is the voltage flowing through this R pi resistance, okay, that is divided by the resistance R pi, that will give you the current flowing through R pi, that will be equal to VB1 minus VE divided by the total resistance R pi plus RB, okay. And similarly, V pi 2 divided by R pi can be written as, so which is the current flowing through this R pi resistance of the Q2 transistor, okay. So VB2 minus VE divided by the total resistance R pi plus RB, okay, R pi plus RB, which was mentioned here. Now we are going to solve for the V pi 1 value and V pi 2 from these two equations, and then those values are going to be substituted in the equation number 2. Okay, so if we solve for the V pi 1, if you take this R pi to the right hand side, that will be equal to R pi into VB1 minus VE divided by R pi plus RB. Similarly, the V pi 2 can be given as R pi into VB2 minus VE divided by R pi plus RB. Now, this V pi 1 equation and V pi 2 equation, we are going to substitute in the equation number 2. Okay, so here what we have, V pi 1 into this term plus V pi 2 into this term, so that we can write after substituting, okay, R pi into VB1 minus VE divided by R pi plus RP, that is nothing but V pi 1 into 1 plus beta divided by R pi plus this one, R pi into VB2 minus VE divided by R pi plus RP, that is nothing but V pi 2 into 1 plus beta divided by R pi, which is equal to VE minus R0. Here we are going to solve for the VE, emitter voltage VE. Now we are going to solve for the VE, emitter voltage VE. Okay, in this equation, we can cancel this R pi and R pi, and here also R pi and R pi will get cancelled. And also here 1 plus beta divided by R pi plus R b is common in the both terms. Therefore, we can take 1 plus beta divided by R pi plus R b as a common term. Therefore, the remaining terms here are VB1 and here VB2 and minus VE minus VE, which is equal to minus 2VE. Okay, VB1 plus VB2 minus 2VE, which is equal to VE divided by R0. Now, I am going to take this term 1 plus beta divided by R pi plus RB to the right hand side. That will divides this right hand side term, which will becomes VE divided by R0 into R pi plus RB divided by 1 plus beta. Okay, now we can take this minus 2VE to the right hand side so that it will become a plus 2VE. Therefore, VB1 plus VB2 is equal to VE by R0 into R pi plus RB divided by 1 plus beta plus 2VE. Okay, if you observe, these two terms are containing the VE. Therefore, we can common the VE. Okay, if you take VE as common, then we have the 2 plus R pi plus RB divided by 1 plus beta into R0. So that we can write the VE equation like VE is equal to VB1 plus VB2 divided by 2 plus R pi plus RB divided by 1 plus beta into R0. That is the equation for the voltage VE. If we consider one-sided output at the collector of the Q2, then V0 is equal to VC2. Here I am assuming I am going to take the one-sided output across the second transistor Q2 collector terminal. Therefore, here VC2 with respect to ground, I am going to take, which is V0, that is nothing but VC2. So here VC2 is a voltage across the resistance RC. Therefore, the current flowing in the resistor RC is nothing but minus GM V pi 2, because the direction of the GM V pi 2 is opposite. Therefore, minus GM V pi 2 into RC, that is nothing but the VC2. We know that GM into V pi. So here GM into V pi we have read, that is nothing but the IC current, which is beta times of IB. What is IB current here? IB current is the current flowing in the base circuit, that is equal to the voltage divided by the resistance, which is nothing but the VB2 minus VE divided by R pi plus RB, which we have already derived it. Okay, so this IB current equation we are going to substitute in this GM V pi equation, so that this GM V pi 2 can be written as VB2 minus VE divided by R pi plus RB into beta into RC, that is the value of the output voltage, okay, which was taken as equation number 3. And substituting the emitter voltage VE value in the equation number 3, okay, this VE equation we are going to substitute in the equation number 3, which is given as V0 is equal to minus beta RC divided by R pi plus RB into VB2 minus VB1 plus VB2 divided by 2 plus R pi plus RB divided by 1 plus beta into R0. Okay, this entire term is the VE equation. Now we are going to simplify this equation. If you take the LCM, we can get it like 2 VB2 plus R pi plus RB divided by 1 plus beta R0 into VB2 minus VB1 minus VB2. Okay, so here VB2 is a one term minus VB2. Okay, if you subtract it, then we can get VB2. Therefore, we can write this equation like V0 is equal to minus beta RC divided by R pi plus RB into, if you take VB2 as common from this VB2, and here this term is also contains the VB2. Therefore, VB2 into 1 plus R pi plus RB divided by 1 plus beta into R0 minus VB1. in the denominator we have 2 pi plus r pi plus rp divided by 1 plus beta into r naught. Okay, so which is the output voltage which was taken as equation number 4. In an ideal constant current source, the output resistance r naught is equal to infinite. If you assume the constant current source IQ is the ideal source, then the resistance R naught provided by that constant current source is infinite. Okay. Therefore, we can substitute R naught is equal to infinite in the equation number 4. So, here R naught is equal to infinite. So, anything by infinite is 0. Therefore, this entire term will be equal to 0. Similarly, in the numerator, this term will be going to 0. Therefore, we will have VB2 minus VB1 in the numerator, and in the denominator we have only 2. Therefore, we can write the V0 equation which is equal to beta RC into VB2 minus VB1 divided by 2 into RY plus RB. Okay, that is the value of the output voltage. Then the differential mode input voltage, which is equal to the VB1 minus VB2, because the differential input voltage is nothing but the difference of the two input signal. Here the input signals are VB1 and VB2, therefore the differential input voltage is VB1 minus VB2. Therefore VB1 minus VB2 can be written as VD. Therefore we can get this equation like V0 is equal to beta RC divided by 2 into R pi plus RB into VD. Therefore, the differential mode gain can be given as, here AD is the ratio of differential mode output voltage to the differential mode input voltage. Okay, we have VD in the right hand side, that we can take to the left hand side in order to get the V0 divided by VD ratio. Therefore, which will be equal to beta RC divided by 2 into R pi plus RB. Okay, that is the differential mode gain AD. And VB1 and VB2 in terms of the VD and VCM can be written as, okay, this input voltages VB1 and VB2 can be written in terms of the VD, differential input voltage, and the VCM, the common mode input voltage, like VB1 is equal to VCM plus VD by 2. Similarly, VB2 is equal to VCM minus VD by 2. Okay, so now two input signals can be written as the sum of the differential mode input signal component and the common mode input signal component. Okay, so which is the sum of the differential mode component plus the common mode input component. Okay, now we are going to substitute these VB1 and VB2 values in the equation number 4 so as to get the common mode gain and differential mode gain. If you substitute the VB1 and VB2 values in the equation number 4, we can get it like V0 is equal to beta RC divided by 2 into R pi plus RB into VD minus beta RC divided by R pi plus RB plus 2 into 1 plus beta into R0 into VCM. Okay, this can be achieved by separating the VD terms and VCM terms. Okay, after applying the VB1 and VB2 values in the equation number 4. This is a lengthy procedure. In the description, you can get this complete derivation. We can write the output voltage in the general form like the differential mode gain, okay, AD into VD plus this entire term can be taken as the common mode gain, ACM into the common mode input voltage, VCM. Therefore, we can say output voltage of the differential amplifier is the sum of the differential mode output voltage, okay, plus the common mode output voltage. VOD is the differential mode output voltage and the VOC is the common mode output voltage. The differential mode output voltage can be given as differential mode gain into the differential input voltage, and the common mode output voltage can be given as the common mode gain into the common mode input voltage. Okay, so where AD is the differential mode gain and ACM is the common mode gain. Therefore, we can write the AD equation from this one like beta RC divided by 2 into R pi plus RB. Similarly, the common mode gain equation is equal to minus beta RC divided by R pi plus RP plus 2 into 1 plus beta into R naught. Suppose if you assume our IQ constant current source is a ideal source, then the resistance provided by the constant current source is infinity. So as the denominator R naught is containing the infinity, this ACM will be equal to 0. The common mode gain for ideal constant current source is 0. Now we are going to get the differential mode gain and common mode gain for the two-sided output voltage, which is a balanced output. Okay, so we are going to take the output voltage across the two collector terminals of the differential amplifier. Therefore, the V0 will be equal to VC2 minus VC1. Here VC2 is the collector voltage of the Q2 transistor and the VC1 is the collector voltage of the VC1 transistor. The differential mode voltage gain, which can be given as AD is equal to beta RC divided by R pi plus RB. Okay, here the only difference between the two-sided output and one-sided output is, here we don't get the 2 in the denominator, because for the one-sided output, okay, the gain is half. So that we will get the 2 in the denominator section, that will get avoided in the balanced output mode or the two-sided output mode. And the common mode voltage gain, which can be given as ACM is equal to 0. So this is about small signal analysis of the differential amplifier. Now we are going to derive common mode rejection ratio, which is shortly called as CMRR. Okay, here CMRR is the common mode rejection ratio. The definition for the CMRR can be given as, it is the ability of a differential amplifier to reject the common mode signal, which is described in terms of the common mode rejection ratio, CMRR. Actually, our differential amplifier is designed to give the differential input voltage, okay, which is the difference of the two input signals, so that we don't need any common mode signals. Okay, so if we apply the common mode signals to our differential amplifier, the output should be equal to 0, but it is not possible because the common mode input voltage is present, which is the average of the two input signals. Therefore, the ability of a differential amplifier to reject the common mode signals, even though if you give the common mode signal to my differential amplifier, it has to reject that signal and it has to give 0 output voltage. The ability of a differential amplifier to reject the common mode signal is called as CMRR. The CMRR is a figure of merit for the differential amplifier. Okay, so as we have the gain bandwidth product in the BJT's normal CA amplifiers, which is a figure of merit, in this differential amplifier, the CMRR is the figure of merit, and which can be given as CMRR is equal to the differential mode gain to the common mode gain ratio. Okay, we can say the CMRR is equal to modulus of AD divided by ACM, where AD is the differential mode gain and ACM is the common mode gain. For the ideal differential amplifier, ACM is equal to 0. Just we have seen, for the ideal differential amplifier, the common mode gain must be equal to 0, so that the CMRR will be equal to infinity. Okay, so here AD divided by 0, which is nothing but infinity. Usually the CMRR will be expressed in the decimal format. Therefore, the CMRR in decibels can be given as 20 log AD by ACM. From the differential amplifier analysis, we can substitute the ACM equation and AD equation, and the CMRR can be expressed like this. Here, the CMRR is equal to AD divided by AC. Here AD is nothing but beta RC divided by 2 into R pi plus RB, and AC is nothing but beta RC divided by R pi plus RB plus 2 into 1 plus beta into R naught. So here I have eliminated a minus in the AC equation because we have taken the modulus for our ratio AD divided by AC, because the CMRR is a positive quantity. In this equation, we can cancel the beta RC and beta RC. Therefore, the above equation can be written as AD by AC is equal to 1 by 2 into, so this term will go to the numerator, R pi plus RB plus 2 into 1 plus beta divided by R pi plus RB. Okay, in the numerator we have R pi plus RB term, and similarly in the denominator we have R pi plus RB term. Therefore, we can divide that numerator and then we can get it like the CMRR is equal to modulus of AD by ACM, which will be equal to 1 by 2 into 1 plus 2 into 1 plus beta into R naught divided by R pi plus RB. So here also we have R naught, which was not mentioned. Okay, this is the equation for the common mode rejection ratio. Now we are going to see one problem regarding the differential amplifier. Determine the differential and common mode gains and the common mode rejection ratio of the differential amplifier shown in the figure. Okay, they have given this differential amplifier circuit, and we need to get the differential mode gain and common mode gain as well as the CMRR for this circuit. And the values what they have given for this circuit is V plus and V minus are the plus 10 volts and minus 10 volts. The IQ constant current source, which was given as 0.8 milliamperes, and RC resistance, which was given as 12 kilo ohms. Okay, and the transistor parameters, beta is equal to 100, and the R naught resistance, which is the equivalent resistance of this IQ current source, that is nothing but the 25 kilo ohms. And we need to assume that the RB resistance is 0. Here RB resistance is equal to 0. And also they have given use the one sided output, and the output was taken across the second Q2 transistor output terminal VC2 with respect to the ground. So the differential mode gain of the circuit can be given as AD is equal to GM into RC divided by 2. In the DC characteristics derivation, we have taken the AD is equal to V0 divided by VD, which is nothing but the GM into RC divided by 2. Here the GM can be given as ICQ divided by VT, okay, ICQ divided by VT into RC. Already we have the 2 in the denominator, and we know that ICQ current is nothing but IQ by 2. Therefore, IQ by 2 into VT into RC, and we have the 2 in the denominator that will get multiplied here, which will be equal to IQ into RC divided by 4 VT. This equation we are going to use in our problem. Therefore, AD is equal to IQ RC divided by 4 VT. Here IQ current is given as 0.8 milliamperes and the RC is the 12 kilo ohms, and 4 into VT is the volt equivalent temperature, that is equal to 26 millivolts at room temperature. Therefore, we can get the differential mode gain AD is equal to 92.3. That is the differential mode gain of this differential amplifier. Next, we need to get the common mode gain. Okay, so the common mode gain ACM, which can be given as minus IQ RC divided by 2 VT divided by 1 plus beta into IQ R naught divided by VT beta. Okay, this is the common mode voltage gain equation. Okay, we can get this equation like, we know that R pi is equal to beta VT by ICQ, and here ICQ in the differential amplifier is nothing but IQ by 2. If you replace ICQ as IQ by 2, we can get the equation like 2 beta VT divided by IQ. We know that the common mode gain ACM is equal to minus beta RC divided by R pi plus 2 into 1 plus beta into R naught. In this equation, we can replace the R pi resistance like 2 beta VT divided by IQ, so which was replaced here. And after taking the LCM, we can write the equation like minus beta RC into IQ. Here IQ will go to the numerator, and the denominator terms are 2 beta VT plus 2 into 1 plus beta into R0. Okay, so in this one we can divide the numerator and denominator with 2 into beta VT. Okay, we can divide the numerator as well as the denominator with 2 beta VT. If you divide the numerator, minus beta RC IQ divided by 2 beta VT divided by this term will becomes 1 plus this 2 into 1 plus beta into R0 divided by 2 beta VT. This 2 and 2 will get cancelled, and in the numerator this beta and beta will get cancelled. Therefore, in the numerator section we have IQ RC divided by 2 VT, and in the denominator we have 1 plus 1 plus beta R0 divided by beta VT. Okay, this is the expression what we have got for the ACM. Now we are going to substitute the values here. Here IQ is 0.8 milliamperes and RC is 12 kilo ohms, and 2 into VT is 26 milliohms, and 1 plus beta. Here beta is equal to 100. Therefore, 1 plus beta is equal to 101 into 0.8, and R0 is given as 25 divided by the 26 millivolts into beta, which is 100. After substituting these values, we can get the ACM as minus 0.237, which is a very, very, very small value. The common mode gain of a differential amplifier is a very, very less value. Therefore, we can get the common mode rejection ratio, which is the ratio of the differential mode gain to the common mode gain. So that can be given as AD is equal to 92.3 divided by the ACM is minus 0.237. As we have taken the modulus, that minus will get cancelled. Okay, this 92.3 divided by 0.237, that will give you the CMRR as 389, which is a large value. And the CMRR in decibels can be given as 20 log 10 into the 389, which is the CMRR. Then we can get the CMRR as 51.8 decibels. Okay, this is the value of the common mode rejection ratio, 51.8 decibels. This is how we have to do the problems of the differential amplifier. In the next class, we are going to see about the differential and common mode input impedances.